Hello! In this video, we're going to learn how to use cookies with JSP. So we'll cover the following topics. First off, we'll find out what are cookies and how we can use them, and then we'll actually explore the cookies API and learn how to write code for reading and writing cookies. Alright, so we have a lot of good things in store in this video. Let's go ahead and get started. So what's the purpose of cookies? And you may have heard of cookies before, but basically cookies allow you to personalize a website for a user. And so in effect, you can actually keep track of any user preferences. Say, for example, you have a news site and the user chose their favorite programming language is Java. Then you can keep track of that and show them Java news in the future. Or if you have a travel site and they frequently fly from a given airport, then you can show them all flights from that given airport. So it allows you to keep track of long-term preferences for a user, even after they close their browser and restart it. All right, so let's look at an example here. So I'll use an Expedia.com travel site. Again, I use this website a lot because I travel frequently between Philadelphia and India. So here in this form, I'll just go ahead and set up my departure city of where I'm flying from, Philadelphia, PA, in the U.S., and I travel to Bangalore a good deal in India. So I'll just set up the departure dates. I'm just making this up right now. My departure date and my return date. But the key here is that once I do a search, Expedia will go off and find flights for me from Philadelphia to Bangalore. Now, the nice thing about it is that Expedia will actually create a cookie and store it on my browser such that when they come back at a later time, or actually when I come back at a later time, Expedia will remember. It's like, hey, your last flight that you searched for was Philadelphia to Bangalore, and here are some new prices. So I'll go ahead and quit my browser right now. And then I'll start up the browser again from scratch. And so now I have my browser back up, and then I actually go into Expedia again, and they'll actually remember information about my previous operation. And again, they're making use of cookies. They're keeping track of my preferences, so they automatically know that I'm going to go from Philadelphia to Bangalore, just as a suggestion. And they make use of cookies for this type of functionality, which is really cool. And I'll actually show you how to write Java code or JSP code for reading cookies and also writing cookies. All right. So again, what is a cookie? Well, it's basically text data that's exchanged between the web browser and server. So this is functionality that's built into the browser. So you have your web browser. When you visit a given server, that browser will send over cookies to that server. And so that's how that Expedia.com website was able to remember my information. It says, oh, great, you've been to Expedia before. They read my cookies, they found out my departure and destination city, and displayed a custom form for me. The site can also create new cookies and send them to my browser to keep track of information for any of my return visits. So that's the idea of a cookie. And so I'll actually show you the server-side code for reading cookies and also writing cookies and sending them back to the browser. Now, what exactly is in a cookie? Well, you can kind of think of a cookie as just like a name value pair. So a cookie has a given name, like in this example, myapp.favoritelanguage, and then the value could be Ruby. All right, so that's one cookie. And the application can actually make use of multiple cookies. So we could have another cookie here called myapp.favoritecity, and then the value could be Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. And your application can actually create many cookies. The max is about 20 cookies per site, per path, but that's more than enough for most examples for building applications. Now, how are cookies passed back and forth? Well, the browser, when it connects to the server, the browser will only send cookies that match that server's domain. All right, so here's our browser. We're connecting to a given website. The browser will only send over cookies that match. So for example, when I connect to Expedia.com, it will only send over cookies from Expedia.com. Likewise, if I was using like maybe CNN.com and connected to CNN, the browser would only send cookies that were set by CNN.com. So they won't switch up and send everything across. Like if I'm at Expedia, it wouldn't send over CNN.com cookies to Expedia, only matches on the actual domain name and the given path of the application. So that's the key there. So, you know, there's no security issues going on or whatever. All right. So where are the cookies? So I'm kind of moving back into my browser. Depending on the browser you're using, there's a different format for doing this. But here with Firefox, I can go under Preferences. And once I'm on the Preferences, then over on the far left, there's a little menu option here for Privacy. And I can select that link for Privacy. Now, it's not really straightforward, but there's a little link here called Remove Individual Cookies. This will allow you to view your cookies. So you can go ahead and select that link, and it'll show you a list of all cookies that are set in this browser for the given domain names. So note here, you see all the sites, the different sites that set cookies, and then the actual cookie name. What I'm doing here is I'm actually searching for cookies that were set by Expedia. So we'll see all these different Expedia sites and the appropriate cookie names. If you select one of these cookies, then it'll actually show you the name of the cookie, the actual content, whatever text that's stored there, the host, and the path. Also at the bottom, you'll see there's a expiration tab. An expiration field. So this will tell you how long this cookie will last. So basically 1 year from today, 1 year from today is when that cookie will expire. So it'll always be on my system until that given time frame comes up. And I'll show you how to actually write the Java code for setting the expiration time for cookies and so on. But anyway, just a nice little behind the scenes tour. All right, so the cookie API. Well, there's a special class called cookie. It's defined in a package javax-servlet.http. This package is given to you for free in all JSP pages. So there's no hard requirement for you to import this package. You automatically get this package. So you can simply make use of the cookie class directly in your JSP page. Now, when you use a cookie, the first thing you need to do is construct it. All right. So here's the actual constructor from the Java documentation. So you create a cookie, you pass in the name of the cookie and the value for the cookie. Now, the name, you can give any name that you want, as long as you're consistent within your application, and the value, you can store any value or any data that you want in the cookie as a string value. All right. So here's some real Java code. You're probably wondering, hey, where's the code? All right. So here's the code that we'll use for actually sending a cookie to a browser. Okay. So let me set this up. So let's say, for example, there's a form. The user can select their favorite programming language, and they can send it over to this JSP page. What this JSP page is going to do is it's going to read that form data for their favorite programming language. It's going to create a cookie, and it's going to send it back to the browser such that later on when they come back to visit our site, you know, a day later, a week later, a month later, we'll remember their favorite language, and then we can customize the output page for their favorite programming language. All right. So let's kind of walk through the code here. So the first line here, request get parameter, favorite language. Again, we're just reading something from the form data. The next thing we need to do is create the cookie. So I say new cookie. I give the name value pair. So the name is myapp.favoriteLanguage. And again, the name could be anything, comma, favlang. That's the variable from the previous line. So that's our cookie object. Now we need to set the actual lifespan for the cookie. How long do we want this cookie to last? So by default, a cookie has a lifespan of 0, which means that once the browser closes, that cookie will expire. So if you want the cookie to last for a longer time, you have to set the lifespan. So here you have to say the cookie.setMaxAge, and you give the age. Now, this is the one part of the API that I just don't like. I wish they could make something easy like setting a duration. You could say 1 month, 2 years, or 5 years or something, but you can't do that. It's not that simple. You have to set the maximum age as the total number of seconds. Oh gosh, I hate that. All right. So anyway, so the bottom line is that you have to do the math, right? So if you want it for 1 week, you have to compute the total number of seconds in a week. If you want it for a year, the total number of seconds in a year. So this example here is for a year. So that's the total number of seconds for a year. And that's the API, and that's just how it is. But anyway, let's get past that. Once we have the cookie created, we set the max age, then we send the cookie to the browser. So we load it up into that response object that's going to go back to the browser. So here I say response.addCookie, and I simply give a reference to the cookie variable. And that's it, basically. So that's for sending back one cookie. If you wanted to send back multiple cookies? Well, you simply create a new cookie object and you say response.add cookie, you know, my cookie number two or whatever. And you repeat that process X number of times. But again, there's a max on 20 cookies per domain per path. But anyway, that's the basic code there for sending a cookie to a browser. All right, so now the browser has a cookie that's been set by our application, by our JSP from that previous slide. Now, when the user returns back at a later time, we want to show them a custom page based on their cookie information. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to read their favorite programming language cookie and then do something with it. So to get a handle to the cookies, I make use of that request object. And I'll say request.getCookies. This will return me an array of cookies. So note here on the left-hand side, cookie with a square bracket. The square brackets means an array. So that's the cookies. Then I check to make sure the cookies is not equal to null because maybe they didn't have any to send over. Once I know we have cookies, then I simply do a for loop. So I set up a for loop, cookie, temp cookie, colon, the cookies. And the cookies is the variable from that previous line. So then I simply go through each one of those cookies and I compare that cookie name to the name that I'm looking for. So I'm actually looking for the cookie named myapp.favoritelanguage. So I simply say, if myapp.favoritelanguage equals tempcookie.getName, then that's the favorite language equals tempcookie.value. So I get the value of that cookie and then I break out of that loop. And then later on in my JSP page, I could maybe use that fave language to display custom news for the user. Like maybe I would hit the database and get something, some information, or I don't know, hit a Twitter feed or something. But at that point, I have the key. I have the actual value of the favorite cookie that the user selected, and I can do whatever I'd like to with it. So in a nutshell, that's how you read cookies from the browser. Now, again, this is kind of very high level. We just saw some code snippets. In the next video, we'll actually write some real code. And I'll pull together a nice little example where we'll have some JSP pages, we're reading cookies, we're setting cookies, and we're building custom pages. So don't worry, I'll pull this all together for you and you'll see a nice working example. All right, so I'll see you in the next video.